The magic man once again. I'm still on the court. The light stayed on. I thought they was gonna go off when I did the other video. Let me see if I can bust another video very quickly. So Federer, he ain't tripping. Nadal fans tripping. Federer fans tripping. Other tennis fans tripping. But Federer ain't tripping. I'm telling you. Tennis preacher, prophet, psychic, coming back at you again with another video. Okay, people, let me tell y'all what I think about this Nadal and his injuries. What should Nadal do? Say if Nadal called me up, Magic Man, what should I do? I need some advice here about how to take my career here the next 4 or 5 months or the rest of the year. We'll deal with the next few months here. Okay, people. Nadal shouldn't play Indian Wells. He shouldn't play Miami. And let me tell you why. It's two reasons why. The first reason is he should do the same thing Federer did to him. Federer didn't play Dubai because he was going to allow Nadal to screw up. And unfortunately, Nadal just didn't lose in Acapulco. He actually is injured. Okay, so that's unfortunate though. So he needs to play the same game back with Federer. Don't play. Let Federer defend the points. And number two, the first thing is, forget this number one thing. Give it to Federer. Let him have it. Let Federer have the number one. Your health is the most important. Because if you ain't got your health, if you injure, your career is going to be cut short. You ain't going to be playing any tennis. Your career is going to be over. So forget that number one thing. Okay. Number two, hey man, Federer ain't going to get anything for Miami. And he ain't going to get anything for Indian Wells. I mean, so he got to defend those. 1,000. Let him defend it. Okay, number three. Now, here is the big reason I'm going to convince Nadal. Okay. People, y'all know I told y'all in that other video I uploaded today, I said that Nadal being injured, it doesn't affect my prediction for the Indian Wells. I was going to take Federer to beat Nadal anyway. If they met in the finals, people, I tell you right now, I usually don't tell people how I'm going to predict until that day before. Y'all know the way I do things. People, I was going to take Federer to beat. I'm talking about both of them brought their level. I'm taking Federer to beat Nadal on the hard court. Okay, so I'm talking about even if Nadal wasn't injured, even if Nadal wasn't injured this year, say if Nadal brought his A game to the Indian Wells and Federer brought his A game, I'm still going with Federer. It'd be like the fifth set of the Australian Open. I'm just going to go back to that. Okay, so this one, I'm going to tell Nadal, honestly, you are a little hurt. You're a little hurt, even if you can play Indian Wells. Do you think you're going to really win it? Honestly. He ain't gonna win it, so why play it? You probably ain't gonna beat Federer in the Indian Wells, and you probably not gonna beat Federer in the Miami, and you probably get put out by somebody else because you hurt. So why even play? That's easy. Don't even go down there. Look what happened to you. A Nadal fan. I think it was a Nadal fan. I didn't even think of this, people. People, Nadal has pulled out of 6 tournaments in the last 3 months. People, he pulled out of what? The Paris Masters, Basel, the ATP finale, the Australian Open, Brisbane, and now this one. He's pulled out of 6 tournaments. So what you gonna do? Play a little bit of the Indian Wells, they have to pull out of that and hurt yourself more, then try to play the Miami, have to pull out of that. So man, let that number one thing go for now, man. Let it go. Let Federer have it. Fine. Okay. He got to defend the Wimbledon, and he got to defend the Miami. He got to defend the Indian Wells, so he got some problems too. Let him have it for now. Okay, so that's it. So I would tell Nadal, do you really think you're going to win? You're probably not going to win Indian Wells. You're probably not going to win Miami. Definitely in the state that you're in now. You ain't going to win, so why waste the time with it? So let it go. So heal up. And people, listen here. I'm going to do a separate video on... that is this video here too. People, Nadal may have to play a limited clay. He may have to lose points. Nadal got to defend 4,500 points on the clay court. He may have to let half of those points go. We don't know. The doctors may tell Nadal, his doctor may tell him, man, screw this French Open trying to defend those points. You may be able to play the French Open, but you need to lay off most of those clay court tournaments. He may have to play a limited clay court season. We got this, because, man, this hip injury is serious. Man, the hip is worse than the knee, man. You know what, people? I had a knee injury, and I had a... And here's the thing about it, people. I had a more... I had a torn meniscus, so that was serious with the knee. But my hip, I didn't have nothing really serious with the hip, people. But people, listen here. I just had a little twitch in the hip. The hip thing scared me more. It made me... It's so sensitive. The hip thing scared me more. The little hip twitch that I had, I was scared to walk, that I feel it. So the hip thing is even worse than the knee. And we know that the hip supports the body more than the knee does. Even though the knee supports the body too. Man, the hip thing is the worst. So Nadal got the hip and the knee, man. He got, man, forget this number one thing. He may not even be able to play a full court, a full clay court season. And he may, I don't know about this now. Y'all, I wouldn't be surprised if Nadal lay out the whole clay court season. I'd be a little surprised, but I wouldn't be totally surprised. So yeah, forget the clay. Man, let this Indian Wells go. That Indian Wells, Federer got to defend 1,000 on each one of those, and you probably gonna win either of those anyway. Okay? Tennis preacher, prophet, psychic signing off. Have a good one.